Hey there guys, it's TJ. Today I'm going to talk to you about a very easy and simple setup to create awesome B-roll in a very compact and small room. So baby, do better if you can do better. You gotta choose. Give me fame or give me pleasure. Okay, let's get started. I'm in my dorm right now. I guess that's how people say it. We call it a cot.
Cool.
Anyway, so this room is very small and it's really hard to create some cool shots in here. I just don't have any space to make anything cool at all. That's what I thought. But then this week I had some great ideas, or good ideas, and I tried those ideas out and they came out pretty cool. So I thought I would share them really quickly with you. This kind of setup can be applied to a lot of different kinds of videos and shots. First off, when you're in a small room, it's pretty hard to create some interesting backgrounds in your videos because, well, everything is really small. So those blurry backgrounds and stuff, not so easy to achieve. A look I really like are those small bokeh balls you can see in the background. I went to Action. It's kind of a dollar store, and I found these small lights. They went on AAAA batteries, and they were LED Christmas lights. I think I bought them for around 1 euro per, so it's really cheap. You don't need a lot of them, maybe like 6 or something, and you can stick them to a wall. I stuck them to my closet because that was a space I had left to stick these on. I used painter's tape because it's easy to pull it off once you're ready. So just use that. These things are very light, so just stick them on a wall and that will already give you some nice bokeh balls. So this is the main tip of this video actually. But let's move on. I had some lighting that I wanted to shoot and use as well. These are the new Aperture 20, so I wanted to use those. These are fairly cheap, but not the cheapest out there. You can definitely get some cheaper alternatives, so I'll leave some links down below on lights you may want to check out. What I wanted to try out is these are very harsh lights. They're not soft at all. And for these kind of shots, you really want some soft lighting hitting the product or the person you're trying to film. So I just searched for a white wall and I bounced the light on that wall. It was in the opposite direction of where I wanted the light to hit the product, but then it bounced on the wall and that became my source. Because it's such a big source, an entire wall, you can achieve some pretty soft lighting as well. In fact, I'm using that lighting setup right now on my face. So if you want to see how that works, just stick till the end and I'll show you real quick. Also, this doesn't have to be your wall. It can be a bed sheet that you hang on the clothing rack. It really doesn't matter. You just want some soft lighting. And that already is a nice look we got there. But it needs some edge lighting. One way you can achieve this is, well, I grabbed another aperture light and I pointed it down there. This time, you don't need to soft it because the harsh lighting will create an interesting edge around your product or a person, like you see this edge right now. Didn't soft it. So just grab it and put it behind the person or behind the product you're trying to shoot and point it at the person or at the product. The light that you're seeing hitting me on the side right here, it comes from behind me and it's pointed at me, and that creates this nice edge. Another cool way to add interest to your shot is by adding RGB. I have this $70, I think, RGB light from Yongnuo. I just put mine above the closet towards the product and it creates this nice blue or whatever color you like it to be. That's the point of an RGB light. Top edge light kind of thing. And that's pretty much all you need to create this interesting image. One thing to note, I blocked out all of my windows. I didn't want any lights coming in from the side or something like that. I just wanted to start pure and use only the lights I wanted in there and not the sun that comes through the windows. So you might want to do the same if you want to really control how your lighting looks. All right, and that's pretty much it. I hope you understood what I was trying to tell you. And let's just show this lighting setup I'm doing here right now because it's pretty similar. The orange lighting you see back there, that's Philips Hue strip. This right here is the Yongnuo I was telling you about and is hitting this wall. On the top there is another aperture light that's hitting me from the back. This is an aperture light and it's hitting this wall, and that wall becomes my key light, and that's it basically. I'm just gonna end this video here. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, I have a couple of others with the same kind of subject. Check them out on my channel, and if you like them, please consider subscribing. That was it for this one. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.